Hi, curl friends! Naturally Rhonda here. For all my curl friends out there, my subscribers, I love you all. Thank you so much for coming back every week watching my videos. If you're new here, then please click that box down below and subscribe. Check out some of my other content. If you like this video, then please give it a big thumbs up. So, like I mentioned in last week's hair tutorial video, I've been doing a lot of voluminous big hair, don't care, just boom, wash and goes. The past at least two wash and goes have been bigger. So I decided for this week's wash and go, I will be doing a more defined look. So for this wash and go, I decided to do the lock method. Well, technically log, because leave-in oil gel instead of leave-in oil cream. My leave-in, I will be using the Aveda Nutriplenish Leave-In Conditioner Nutrient-Powered Hydration Detangles and Protects. Now, this product and the next product I'm about to mention came in my July 2020 curl box. If you have not seen that curl box unboxing video, I will leave that in the cards up above and the description box down below. So then after the leave-in, my O oil will be the Aveda Nutriplenish Multi-Use Hair Oil. For my G, I had to bring out Bae. All the curl friends know what I'm talking about. My favorite gel, Wetline Extreme Gel. All right, so enough of the chit chat. Let's just hop into the wash and go. My hair is already shampooed, conditioned, deep conditioned, and detangled. I shampooed and conditioned with the matching products from Aveda. I talked about those in the curl box unboxing. So again, if you haven't seen that video, then please check that one out after you finish this video, of course. First things first, my handy dandy spray bottle of water. I like to go in on wet hair. So I have mixed emotions about spray leave-ins. It's not my favorite form, but I did get a really, really good wash and go from actually two different Cream of Nature leave-in conditioners. My favorite would probably be from the Cream of Nature's Argan Oil Perfect 7 or 7-in-1, something like that, leave-in. I have a video on that. I will put that up above in the cards if you want to check that out. Okay, this seems similar. It's like a creamy kind of leave-in. Ooh, the smell is very similar to the shampoo and the conditioner, which to me is kind of a perfumey kind of salon smell. I think that was like 5 pumps, so I'm gonna go in with like 5 more. No, that was like 10 pumps that I just did. I will be the first one to say I am heavy-handed. Now I'm just taking some of the oil, and this oil seems pretty standard. I think I did about 5 pumps of the oil for this section, and I'm just raking and using the praying hands method. This is my hair with just the leave-in and the oil. Now I'm going to subsection before I apply the gel. Wet it down a little more. This actually isn't good what I'm doing, because I have not tried these out to see if they're gonna mix well together. Y'all don't do this. Try out your products first. So let's just hope that it works. So far so good. I thoroughly coat my hair in the gel. You know, Wetline is a very, very thick gel. And I love that it's so thick because it weighs down my hair and elongates my curls. Okay, I feel like it's sufficiently coated. And now I just do my little shingling. Ooh, honey, yes. This is my first section, yes. This wash and go is gonna be super cute, I can tell already. So I'm gonna just keep going with this log method, leave-in oil gel, and I will be back when the product is all in. Alexa, play Beyonce.
Shuffling songs by Beyonce on Amazon Music.
Do anything to win it.
So the product is all in, and this is what it's looking like wet. All right, so I'm just gonna go sit under my hooded dryer and I will be back when my hair is all dry. Oh, hey. No, I'm joking. So my hair is dry. I was under the dryer for maybe like an hour, 15 hours, 20 minutes. Actually, my hair is like 95% dry. My roots are still a little damp, but such is life. So these are my finished results. I'm not surprised. I knew I was going to love this wash and go because of Wetline. Like, that's just bae. So my hair definitely has a hold to it. Definitely has the gel cast. But honestly, were we expecting a wash and go without a gel cast when I was using Wetline? No, we weren't expecting that. We knew that there was going to be a gel cast. And how do we fix a gel cast? Oil. So I'm just going to use some more of that Nutriplenish oil from the Aveda curl box that I received and scrunch out this crunch as soon as my hair is 100% dry. Oh, I almost forgot. So my shirt, as you can see, I'm going to zoom in on this so you can read it. This came from Social Soiree by Kiara. And I was thinking, because I actually have quite a few like pro-black shirts from black-owned companies, I was thinking maybe I should do like a lookbook. I don't know. Part of me wants to do it because I have so many of them and it would be great to have them all in like one video, because people constantly ask me, oh, where'd you get that shirt? Where'd you get that shirt? Where'd you get that hoodie? But I'm not really that stylish and fashionable. I feel like I wear clothes, but I'm not like a fashionista. I might enlist my sister to help me out with that one. She's definitely more trendy than I am, so we'll see. Maybe. But that's about it for this Wash and Go Wednesday video. This is the point in the video where I like to point your attention to some of my other content, like another one of my bomb Wash and Go videos and one of my favorite twist out videos, which is a bit of foreshadowing because next week's video will be a twist out. So stay tuned. I love you for watching. Y'all please be safe out there and I'll see you in the next one.